Son standing right here next to me. Hey man, we got to get together, get all kids together, so we can have one big happy family reunion, all of us together. All right, I'll see you. Love you, man.
That's my partner. He always be looking out for me, and I always do the great job. I like doing the work for my brother.
Thank you so much for everything. We appreciate you. Nothing but love. Eternity.
Known your father since before he was born, and I have watched him grow into be the finest man he could possibly be. I loved his mother, who is my best friend, and his love for her was just too much. It was grand.
This here is me, who I am. I am the greatest, always and forever. All right.
Happy, happy birthday. I wish I could turn up with you, but I'm going to turn up in some other spaces. But you've always been a system of humor and support and guidance to me. And so all that you are to other people, I hope that all those people show up for you and they turn up for you in that same manner. Have a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful celebration. You definitely, definitely deserve it. And I'll talk to you soon.
My name is Ken Campbell. I first want to ask you to forgive me for not being there in person. Al and I have been friends for what is now approaching 20 years. And honestly, he's more like a brother to me than simply a friend. The only one that I love, respect, and admire more than Al Carter is my mother, who unfortunately having health issues that prevent me from actually being there this evening. Al, thank you so much for being a mentor, teacher, friend, and brother. I absolutely love and appreciate you, brother Carter. God bless you and your family. Thank you. From Ken Campbell.
On behalf of the Holy Worship Ministries, we're in the building. Just so grateful to be here to celebrate your 50th with you. It is a milestone. Yeah. Everything looked beautiful. We had a good time. The food was great. The music. Thank you, DJ, for the music. And we got our dance on. We got our eat on. And we got our celebration on with you. I pray that God bless you with many more. All right.
How you doing, my little brother? I've known you for over 20 years now. I just want to give you your flowers, you know, because when we were down in the dirt at Paul D. West, you know, you stood by me and I stood by you, and we've been friends ever since. But I just wanted to know, man, I love you. You are my brother, for real. Whether we have the same mother or not, I classified your mother as my mother. So you're my brother forever. Our kids were small when we first met. Now they all grown. I just want you to know that I love you, man. Forever.
What's up, brother? I just want to say happy birthday, man. Happy 50th. You're such a big inspiration for us, man. Internally and out in what you get to release in the world. We just thank God for you. We want to dedicate this happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you.
For a short period of time, but I knew like I knew you for a minute, you know what I'm saying? I appreciate everything you brought to my church house. I remember the first day you walked in, and I told you to come back, and you did. I appreciate it. I appreciate your missus, because she did her thing. I want to definitely go say committee, she did her thing, for real. She did her thing. And I want to tell you, from one black man to another, I love you, for real.
Okay, Ryan and Brian, here comes the competition. Psych. When I first seen you though, you had this serious look on your face. You was always looking serious. So it was kind of intimidating at first. But then as I got to know you, I said, you know what, this is really a good guy. And you really do have a good heart. You really, really are an intelligent man. And I appreciate you. I appreciate the pictures. Good thing is you're a natural brother, sincerely from the heart. Everything that you bring to the table, we really appreciate you. We love you. And Sister Sabri, we love you too, because both of y'all brought a lot to holy worship. So we appreciate y'all.
What can I say about Al? Oh my God, it's been some years. Over the years that I've known you, you've always been a great guy, a great friend. Speak your mind. That you do, you speak your mind. I appreciate you for being there for my sister, the kids. I just appreciate you for the person that you are. I miss all the fun when we had at McDonald's every now and then. I appreciate you and thank you for being the man that you are and being yourself.
Most people just call me Al Prentice. Me and my husband and my family, we call him son. We are kill parents, uncle and aunts, cousin. So we call him family and we are very, very, very happy that he's a part of it.
Divine Soul Kitchen from Florida. Mr. Carter, you are also a person that I have met online many, many, many years ago. And tonight is the first moment ever that I'm finally manifesting the physical presence. I am beyond humbled, gloriously happy to be here and share this importance with all of you. This is soul, this is beauty, this is love, and this is forever, eternity. Yay. I love you guys. Thanks for having me.
Hi everybody, my name is Mykeela, y'all know me. That's my daddy. I just wanna say I'm glad to be here. This is my first time doing an all right party. I'm glad doing this for Pop Bear. I just want to say that he's always been someone I looked up to forever. He's the smartest man I know in this whole entire universe. Like, I always come to him with questions and he's always like, go find out for yourself. And I'm like, you have all the answers. You know everything.
Right. Yeah.
Like,
right.
He always have an answer for everything. And he always make you think differently and just like, hey, use your noggin. So I love you and I'm glad that you've been in my life this whole entire time. I'm glad to be here to celebrate this wonderful bar party with you.
Yay! I'm Crystal, aka Avery. I am the future daughter-in-law. I will be a Carter soon. 8 years. I met Al 8 years ago at 2209. If anybody know what 2209 is, y'all know. Anybody know, you know. And he was in a car with Mama Dean, and they were sitting, I don't know why y'all was sitting in the driveway, but I came over, and I was walking up, and they both stopped me. And I think from then, we've been like this. We've been eye to eye, me and Al, like herbs and essential oils, and we have a bond of our little own, besides this Carter over here. But you have done a great job with your kids. Especially your boys, your men, excuse me, they're not boys, your men. Your twin over here, I look forward to you in the future, because this is your twin. Y'all look just like, but no, definitely you. I want to thank you personally for raising this man here. He's amazing. I see where he gets a lot of his self from. So I'm honored to be with the Carter.
Who you got here? Introduce yourself.
Malachi Carter, third generation. I'm the oldest son, the Alpha and the Omega. He almost wasn't here. He was the second thought, you know what I'm saying? Not the first. But the first time I met my dad, I was looking up at the light, and for some reason he wanted to cut the umbilical cord himself. I said, what my dad doing? Like my sister said, you know, my dad know everything. It's like a walking dictionary. It's just crazy. It's like, I didn't even, when Google first came out, we didn't use it for the first 5 years. It was like, why? Yeah, so yeah. I want to say I appreciate you for opening up my mind and in an environment where that's not common. And always, even though you was working all the time, every weekend you would take us somewhere, every weekend. I don't care if it was just Best Buy. Somewhere, and then every, you know, at least once a month, you'll try to take us somewhere that's outside of our 50-mile radius, you know? So showing your kids different stuff, open up their mind to different things, you know? And also, thank you for letting us be a kid, you know, letting us play video games and throwing footballs and not super serious, and just head in the books, because I feel like the best kids are well-rounded, has a balance, you know? So we didn't miss out on being social. That's why I can speak to y'all now, because we were social. We was just in the books and libraries. We was able to be kids, you know? And thank you for the times y'all was overprotective, where I wanted to do more, like play with the kids in the neighborhood, but I understand the kids in the neighborhood wasn't the safest kids to play with, you know, until I got older and them same kids was in jail and started dying, you know? So, you know, stuff I didn't understand as a kid that I understand now that I'm a parent. Appreciate you for all that, and for continuing to be a parent as an adult. Cause, you know, you could've clocked out at 18 and be like, you're on your own, but you know, you still give me advice and help me with stuff and talk to me, you know, as long as it ain't before 8:30, cause you old now and it gets sleepy. But, you know, but if I call you before then, you got all the advice in the world. So I appreciate it, and I love you, and yeah.
Well, yeah, I know it's time for the youngest one. Well, I ain't the youngest one. I ain't the youngest one, but I was in
the... Yeah, yeah, I'm the youngest one right now.
I'm in the building.
Yeah, the youngest son, talk to him. The youngest son in the building, still breathing, still alive, and I appreciate that.
And that comes from appreciation from my dad, and I appreciate you because you did a lot of stuff for me. You even like reverse psychology me into graduating. So you ain't gonna do it, boy. You ain't gonna graduate. I was like, yes, I am. I'm gonna graduate, and I'm gonna prove it, and I'm gonna. Next thing you know, I'm graduating and stuff. He like, I knew it. I knew it all along. I'm like, so you said I proved the point to myself? It's crazy, but no, that's real. And I appreciate it. I appreciate us just going through different things, and I appreciate the bad times, I appreciate the good times, I appreciate everything that you taught me, because everything you taught me made me to what I am today. And also, like, it just made me to the person I am today. That's the most I can say, because I love it. I mean, and also the open-mindedness you gave me, because we could have been thinking like any other person in these streets that had a thing, because that's all we see. But you know what I mean, you gave us the different mindset to think outside the box. And as we start thinking outside the box, we open that, we're like, oh, it's everything, I can do this, I can do that. There's mountains we can climb, what's going on? Why are we stressing? So yeah, so I appreciate all that, because that's what made me what I am today. And I love you, and I appreciate you, of course, for making this all possible. Yeah. I know I came in late, I'm sorry. I'm gonna make it up. Yeah, my girl gonna cook something. we gonna talk about it. But yeah, but anyway. Yeah, I appreciate it, and we're going to start getting more connected as far as family. I want to start having more events, so I just want to put that out there too, because you never know, and that's real. So, I love you, and I appreciate everything you've done for me, from the bottom and the top of my heart.
Come on, talk to her.
All right. Okay. Let's get this party started.
They got them drinks glowing. Woo! Woo!